another shooting fighter. Come on, y'all, put y'all right black fist in the air. We want to show a sign of unity to Trayvon Martin and a sign of unity to the world that we will stand up against justice. We can come together in unity in 2013.
That's right.
Because you want to really know why? You want to really know why they can murder Trayvon Martin and come back with a not guilty verdict? Because they don't see our unity enough. They don't see black people standing together enough. All is what they see. All is what the media shows them is the black people murdering and killing one another wholesale. So they say, what the hell are you mad about when you murder and kill your own every day? Every day. In the streets of Chicago during the 4th of July weekend, over 12 black people were killed in a one weekend span, man. In Chicago.
That's
so
right.
The black on black violence and genocide is at an extremely alarming rate and at an all time. And that's an issue that we have to deal with
as
a people in America. But black family, what makes this movement very serious in what we're doing as a black man and as a black male in America, do you know that now that they can murder us and get away with it as they've been doing in this country, it gives a message to those megalomaniacs out there, those racists out there, that it's open season on black people. It's open season on the black man. That's the kind of message that they will send to a racist Aryan nation or a racist who don't care about people and may have the thought about shooting them anyway. Now they know that in the state of Florida, they can shoot us and get away with it. But we send a message and no, hell no. If you shoot one of us, we're going to come out by the tens and thousands and maybe the millions if we have to. So we got to show our unity, family, more so now today than we ever have showed it before.
Yeah.
Because what they have showed us, that black life in America has zero value at all. There's no value to black life in America. So our demonstrations will show the world that we will stand together. We don't care if it's 100 degrees out here. They will say, hell, black people are standing today for Trayvon Martin.
That's right.
Not only we're standing for Trayvon Martin, we're standing for injustice, racism everywhere in America.
That's right.
And what we're doing today is that. We always brag about the struggles of the 60s. We always talk about the civil rights struggle and about what our ancestors did.
That's right.
But what we're doing today is that. We are the new generation today. We are the new civil rights movement today. This is the new struggle with us today. Fighting back. We're taking a stand. So don't take what you're doing because you're standing by thinking that you're not doing nothing. What you're doing is very significant. It is very important for our history. Because our history is being recorded in this time and in this hour. And this is our response. And
so,
what a wonderful job.
Right.
We're civilized, we're obedient, we're disciplined, and we're exercising our rights to exist as human beings, and we refuse the people to shoot us down like dogs, like animals in the streets. So we're taking a stand. We're taking a strong, progressive stand. And in a momentarily, we're going to join with our brothers and sisters from the People's Organization for Progress, and we're going to put our feet on the pavement and we're going to march. We're going to march strong. We're going to march in the heat. We're going to march in the sun to let them know we don't get tired. We don't get weak. When you attack us, we get stronger. We get stronger and we stay longer because we want to show them that we are too black. Too black. Too black and too strong to be broken, to be weakened by an unjust racist system. So give yourselves another strong black hand. We gotta continue to big ourselves up. Big ourselves up. This is not a one-man show. We wanna hear from the community as well.
Freedom tomorrow.
If the community wanna come out and express your outrage and about this no good racist verdict decision? Then we want y'all to come forward. Come forward, the community can come forward as well and express your outrage. Long live!
Long live!
Long live!
Trayvon Martin.
Long live!
Long live!
Trayvon Martin.
Before I even begin, I would like for all movement, all motion, all noise, I want to give a moment of silence to Trayvon Martin, for 5 seconds. A moment of silence for 5 seconds for Trayvon Martin and every other lost soul that we lost in this city and all over the country.
Let us bring on a sister from the community and drop a few words on us to express our outrage at what happened to Trayvon Martin.
I'm a graduate of John Jay College of Criminal Justice, and Constitutional Law and Criminal Law. And I'm telling you that there are books that hold laws called the Black Code. The reason why Trayvon Martin was able to be murdered and this rape is because of those laws called the Black Codes that still exist. They say that a black man does not have the same rights as a white man. That a white man will never stand trial or be convicted for the murder of a black man. This is why that Kangaroo Court was set up, to let you know that those Black Codes are still in effect. We have got to march on Washington and make them repeal those laws and abolish them. Not just make laws to amend them. We gotta get rid of the Black Code. When our black boys are accosted because there's maybe 4 of them on the corner and they are searching them, it's because of the Black Code that states no black men may congregate on any corner at any time without a preacher standing near them. More than 2, okay? So no laws. Pick up a copy of Black's Law Dictionary. Know what they're doing to you. It is not just Trayvon that they're killing. It's all of us. Every black boy in this country is in danger right now. And until we make these laws illegal, abolished, it will continue to happen. Take your money out the bank. Cash in your stock. Cash in all of your insurance. That the 95% are heard. They only understand money. This is a capitalistic society. Right. And they will know when you take your money out the bank that you mean business.
Yeah. All right, let's give the sister a strong hand. Let's give the sister a strong hand, y'all. Let's give her a strong hand. Let's give Melanie Summers a strong hand, y'all. Strong hand, y'all. We can do better than that. We need to do better than that. Brothers and sisters, again, let's make the circle bigger. Let's fill in the empty spaces. 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 We see a car coming. We see a car up. NABC, get on that. Hold your positions. Everybody hold their positions in the circle. Hold your positions. Let's fill in the empty spaces. Let's fill in the empty spaces. We got another speaker coming on, sis. We got another speaker. We got another speaker coming on. See, again, this is the people's rally right here. So we're going to let the people speak, voice their outrage today, family. So let's give a strong hand to, Sister Adiva, y'all.
Good evening, everybody. And I say God because I'm going to put God first in all of this. They call me the diva because I represent divine, inspirational, virtuous, and anointing. And this time, I'm going to open up by saying a change is going to come. No, a change is not going to come. A change is here. We need to change the way we are thinking. And you want to know how we're going to do that? We're going to do it in numbers. We're going to do it in an organization. because one, we are going to support.